talented as hell.
We're here with Derrick James, one of the best coaches in the history of boxing. We're moments after Manny Pacquiao against Dennis Ugas. Coach, you had a, first of all, tell me about your fight tonight early on the card.
We had Frank Martin fighting. He fought, I don't know, Ryan.
Very long, complicated name.
Oh, yeah, yeah, very long. Yeah, yeah. But
tough fighter. 30, very tough guy. 30 fights, 10 knockout wins.
Right, and it was, so it was a pretty tough fight, but he went the distance, a 10 round decision. And 10, what's funny about it, to hear it, it's like 100 to 90, which is like you won every round. It was pretty funny, but it was good. It was a great fight. Good fight.
You need to put in rounds for a young fighter.
Right, no
you need
doubt,
to get experience
no
because if you ever get there down the line, you
right
haven't been there.
Right.
And he's in great condition. Frank's a warrior. And then Burley, of course, fought.
Right, right. Burley had a draw, a split draw, which was like, I don't know what they were looking at. Because he really controlled the first 3-4 rounds. Maybe the guy had a round or two in between, but not like to where you had 3-3, but hey man, it's on.
It's boxing,
right.
You take it as it comes. You're a great kid, you're a great fighter.
Right, 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 right.
What makes you tough, or what is it? The trials and tribulations is what
break,
make you correct.
Tough, right, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Now we're going to the main event. I saw you were sitting a few feet away from the ring. We all know it was supposed to be Errol Spence in the ring tonight.
Right.
It was Ugas.
Right.
What do you think of the Ugas fight, Coach?
Well, Ugas fight was good. I'm gonna tell you why. Because before the fight, I went to the locker room, Ugas locker room, and I told him, I said that it's unfortunate that we're not fighting tonight, but at the same time, I think that it may be set up for you to win. I mean, it's a line, the stars aligned for you to win. Because it's a situation you just fall right into and you just do your thing. And I told him, make the best of your opportunity, and he did it. I mean, so it's like dream do come true. There's a guy who, his name should be the American Dream. I don't take Laura's name. You know, it's amazing.
Errol tweeted tonight and said, congratulations, good
right
stuff. Like
right,
he was happy for him, even though I'm sure inside he's like, man. If,
right.
Now let's go to the next question. What happens if it's Errol Spence in there with Manny tonight and not Ugas?
I think that he would have broke him up. I think that he would have been just too physical, too strong. The physicality of Errol Spence, and Ugas is not a physical fighter, but he fought Pacquiao physically. Because what you do with a guy like that is you impose your will. If you think about it like this, what beats speed? Timing. So, I mean, everybody was talking about speed. I know the Fortune guy in LA was talking about, he said some stuff about Errol, but whatever. And, but you gotta like your guy. You're supposed to go for your guy, right? You're supposed to go for your
back,
guy.
Back your fighter, always.
That's right.
Have the, believe in him. That's
right,
why you're coaching him.
Right, that's right. And so I think that that's really what it was, but I mean, it was just, the physicality was just too much. I mean, it's not like he's fighting Margarita, who's a lot slower, no timing, reaction time slow. It's like these are bigger, faster, stronger guys. And I mean, not, well, not faster, but the reaction time was better than Pacquiao's reaction time. I think he's not accustomed to people reacting to him so fast. And so that's what it was. And listen, somebody said something about his age. I said, listen, don't talk about his age because he's the one 40 years old fighting these young guys. So you can't bring it up. Can't mention the age because he doesn't have an issue with it. And he thinks
he beat Keith Thurman?
Like this, he still thinks he can rock with these young guys, and that's really what it is. If he believes it, don't bring it up.
So let's ask you this. After the fight, Ugas is interested in fighting Errol Spence. What happens in that fight, Errol Spence, Ugas?
I mean, I'm always go for me, man. I mean, you know, I'm chilling myself. I'm going to go for myself.
Where
is
this going?
And so I think that it'll be a good fight. Ugas is an amazing fighter still. But Errol will be able to, you know, beat him also.
Are you guys interested in the Crawford fight, or you wait to see?
I mean, listen, I'm on whatever Errol wants. Errol said he wanted to be the undisputed champ. So, and him being the undisputed champ, that's where he has to be able to fight Terrence Crawford.
Sean Porter Crawford, who you got, Coach?
I just want to see an entertaining fight. I mean, I think the winning part, that's up to them. I mean, but like both of them are winners. Because both of them are support. I think they're friends, really good friends, and they both make millions of dollars together. Do that.
No, it'll be a big fight. Let's see what
right
happens.
Right.
How's Errol Spence doing? Any updates from last week when I first talked to you?
Well, I mean, I talked to him tonight after the fight.
What did he say?
He just called and just asked about his guys. I don't know if he even saw the fight. I just think he asked about how, you know, about Frank and Burley. That's really what his main concern was, his guys.
See?
And so, he was in good spirits, though.
And Coach, what did you think of breaking news today? Very, very fortunate. I'm happy. Gervonta Davis was in a plane crash, and he walked away with almost no damage, which is incredible.
Right.
Did you happen to follow that, see that?
My son called me talking about it, but I was like, man, I'm in the back getting ready for a fight. I'm sorry. I said, I'm unfortunate, but I can't have a conversation with him.
Yeah.
He told me about it, and I think it's a very unfortunate situation.
So.
That, hey, man, any plane crashes, we're flying every day all the time, you know what I mean? So, you know, it's like, I don't know.
It always crosses your mind, every time I fly.
It's there, but I don't look at it.
Correct.
It's there, but I don't look at it that direction, you know what I mean? I don't let my mind go that far, but you know it's possible.
If this was indeed Manny Pacquiao's last fight, how do we remember him? I mean, he's an icon, he's 8th division champ.
Remember him as a great fighter, man. And really, I think even more than a great fighter, but a guy who stepped up to all the challenges. I mean, a guy who's a great humanitarian, a guy who's probably one of the greatest Filipinos in history, other than the Filipino general that led them to freedom, you know what I'm saying? In some war, somebody, I mean, that, like, is he, I mean, because he believes in his people and he gives back to his people. And that's like the dopest thing. That's what I believe in, giving back to your people, helping your people out. That's really what he's doing. Because a lot of people talk about it. He gives his money, but he say, okay, how can I really fix it from the inside out?
He's genuine about it. He doesn't talk about it. He does it. Right. People come up to him in L.A., homeless, they need money for food. He gives them money. He's not for the cameras, hey, everybody, look at me. Right. He's just a really genuine, good dude. And if this was his last fight, wish him the best. Hopefully he goes to become president and help his people. And if he does come back, who does he fight? What do you think? Is the Spence fight?
I think if he comes back, he fights Amir Khan.
It's a good fight?
I think that. Only because it's like, this is another good fighter. And neither one of them have anything to win or lose. It's just two guys to fight each other. And I don't think a fight for Errol is for him. I mean, this weekend proved that when Errol was injured, you see how the ticket sales went. You see how the people...
The hotel prices in this hotel, let me tell you, did I tell you what happened?
No, what happened?
Hotel prices were like $300. When Earl wasn't fighting, they went down to 60. I'm not complaining because I can stay and afford this place. Right. Otherwise, Derek, I can't afford $300 a night.
And then it's like the tickets to the fight I heard went down. Also.
From 39,000 to 13,000, they went down to 3,000. Still a lot of money, 2,000.
Right. Right.
But yeah, but listen, Earl's a great fighter.
Right.
He doesn't talk. He's not a foul mouth. He's not braggadocious. But people love him. And they watch. I've been in his fight, 60,000.
He's a fighter.
30,000, yeah. And he's undefeated. And he just gets the job done. And he's a good family man.
Yeah.
So people gravitate towards him.
Right.
But him and Manny would have been a legendary fight.
No.
Things happen in life. No one could control. It happened for a reason. We can't see the reason right now. But
if you think about it like this, with the type of fight that Errol Spence has been putting up on a consistent basis, maybe it was like God's will, just like said, listen, we don't want that to happen to Manny, go out like that. He would have imposed his will. That's what Ugas supposed to couldn't get past the jab.
Yeah. No, it was an interesting fight. A lot of rounds were close.
Right, yeah, definitely.
And, you know, it depends on a couple of factors. If they deducted a point for a low blow, which was a clearly low, you know, but they didn't.
One shot.
Yeah.
I mean, but they could have took a point away from him, and because it was Manny, I thought they would have.
Yeah, but I'm saying they didn't, so it doesn't matter. But if they did, it would change a little bit, maybe not by a lot. But Derek, what's next for you now?
Hey man, I'm going on holiday. I mean, I'm going home. I'm gonna cool out and just
enjoy life a little bit.
Work, man. I have a full time job. I gotta go to work. Build my business back up. Boxing been taken away from my business, so I gotta go home.
Take care of what's important. I saw in a video you were live with Charlo. You have an elevator in your house. Why do you need an elevator, Derek? How many stories do you have? Six stories? Seven stories?
First of all, the elevator came with the house.
You didn't build it?
I didn't build it.
Okay.
What happened was somebody built the house, but the budget went over budget, and they had to sell it. So
okay.
They never lived in it, and they hadn't finished the yard. So we had to do all the irrigation and everything. So it was like,
is there a basketball court? Is there a basement, tennis court?
Man, I got a pond and
that's awesome.
What else?
A panic room, like in the movies?
Can't tell them everything,
but it's a beautiful house and it was very impressive. Like, it's cool to have an elevator. Just
I'm born in the projects, man. So think about that. A kid born in the projects. Grew up very financially
challenging, as they say. Yeah.
Challenged to grow up and have a house with elevator in it and a theater in your house. And
it's a blessing. Man, why not?
Can't beat that.
But you work hard, Derek.
I work 7 days a week. Every day. I literally work every day. So, you know,
hard work, whatever you do in life, there's results.
No education. No college education.
Let me tell you, you know, Kobe Bryant had some great sayings. One of them was, I have nothing in common with lazy people.
That's right.
If you're not going to keep the same level of intensity working, right. don't mess with, don't talk
I
to me.
I saw that when he said, you tell the players, that I wouldn't even talk to them. They work hard.
Yeah.
That's dope, man.
He used to come in the locker room, not talk, to take his shoes and walk out. He wanted everybody to be like him.
Right, because the thing about it is to inspire people to be great. And inspire people to be charitable, inspire people to be all these other things. And that's the key element. I mean, I think that makes America great. That makes America and the world great. It's to inspire people to be great and inspire people to be charitable.
That's it. And that's really Manny Pacquiao as well. So Derrick James, Derrick D. James on Twitter. Everybody follow him. Stay
not Twitter,
tuned.
Instagram,
sorry. Why not Twitter?
Hey, man, too much stuff. I don't know.
Okay.
I don't know how to work my email, text messages. And I look at, I'm not into it that much.
Okay, it's 1 a.m, I got confused. So there you have it, stay tuned. I gotta drive back to LA in a couple hours, go see my son, and then back to the grind in the afternoon, and something to cover.
Right.
Derrick D. James on Instagram. So there you have it, stay tuned guys. FeesNewsReporting.com, I'll be back reporting.
Thank you.